Alright, so now I'm going to work out the details of 48. I'm going to be quick about the Laplace transform step. So you might want to check the previous problem to show some of the details there. Alright, so I take the Laplace transform and I get capital Y of S times S squared plus 2S plus 1 minus 2S plus 1 minus 4 is equal to e to the negative 5S. And capital Y of S is equal to 2S plus 3 over s squared plus 2s plus 1 plus e to the negative 5s times 1 over s squared plus 2s plus 1. Alright. Okay. I'm going to complete the square in the denominator. After I complete the square in the denominator, I'm going to factor off this 2, right? And then I'm going to try to get whatever linear term is in the denominator after square completion in the numerator. So, but I'll factor the 2 off first, leaving me with s plus 3 halves in the numerator. And then I'll complete the square in the denominator to get s squared plus 1. Oh, squared. Ah, this isn't a big deal. Right? Yeah. Right? 1 times 1? Yeah, that's perfect. Oh, great. Okay, so this is a repeated root problem. Plus e to the negative 5s times 1 over s plus 1 quantity squared. Okay. So in the numerator here, I have 2, and then I add an s plus 1 plus 3 halves. But I can't add 1, so I'll subtract 1, too, and then I get an s plus 1 quantity squared. Here, I just have an e to the negative 5s times 1 over s plus 1 squared. That's just hanging out. That is a time delay te to the negative t term. So then I have a 2 times this much, right, is an s plus 1, and it cancels with 1 over that s plus 1 is here, so this is an s plus 1, and then 3 halves minus 1 is going to be a 1 half, and then this is multiplying 1 over s plus 1 quantity squared again, and I add this e to the negative 5s times 1 over s plus 1 quantity squared. So, if I take the inverse transform of this, this is y of t. This term right here is table entry 12. That's 2 e to the negative t. And the 2 hits this 2, so that's a 1. And then this is table entry farther down. It's a t multiplication problem. So this is t e to the negative t. I don't know, maybe 16? Somewhere in there, 17? And this becomes a u5t, the exponential speaking of a time delay. Looking at table entry number 5, I take the inverse transform of this, but I already know it. It's te to the negative t. But I have to time delay everything 5 seconds, so I get t minus 5, e to the negative t quantity minus 5, right? That's the solution. I guess one thing that I can say is that this part right here, that has to deal with the homogeneous solution due to the initial conditions. You can track its existence back. This has to do with the hammer strike, and evidently the hammer strike excites the second of the two homogeneous solution types, the TE to the TE to the negative T. The reason for that is because a hammer hit like that basically is related to velocity.